Hit the road, sport. Keep the tip. You ain't getting other people's hats and coats no more neither.
Why'd you do that?
Because you're with me now.
I don't know anything about you.
I was raised on a farm in Mooresville, Indiana. My mama died when I was 3. My daddy beat the hell out of me because he didn't know no better way to raise me. I like baseball, movies, good clothes, fast cars, whiskey, and you. What else you need to know?
So, what sort of gangster movie is Public Enemies? Well, more than a Johnny Depp vehicle, it's a Michael Mann project, which means the surfaces are sleek and elegant, yet the moral rot underneath keeps threatening to spoil the party. Director and co-writer Mann, who shot much of Public Enemies in Chicago, has long been one of the most ardent and stylish of contemporary Hollywood's chroniclers of crime and punishment. In everything from Thief to Heat to The Insider, Mann's work is built on the idea of the hunter and the hunted. This continues with Public Enemies, which focuses on the last year and a half in the short, highly publicized life of John Dillinger, played by Johnny Depp. The other side of the coin here is Melvin Purvis, played by Christian Bale. He's one of J. Edgar Hoover's newly installed G-men, who in real life, and to some degree in this movie, had their moments of astonishing ineptitude as they coped with a variety of public enemies. This film, though, is primarily a live-fast, die-young Chicago love story between Dillinger and a hat-check girl, Billy Frechette, half French-Canadian, half Menominee Indian. She's played by Marianne Cotillard, who won an Oscar for La Vie en Rose, and for better or worse, it's this relationship that dominates Public Enemies. The movie takes a while to get going. The script never really gets behind Dillinger's eyes, and while Depp is good, I think Mann makes the mistake, not uncommon with movie gangsters, of going straight past humanizing the subject into romanticizing him. On the other hand, if you have any taste for the way Mann can stage, photograph, and propel an action sequence, there's a terrific addition to Mann's canon in Public Enemies, in the gun battle between the FBI and Dillinger's men in northern Wisconsin, which Mann builds into a fantastic 15 minutes of cinema. Everything works. And the way Mann and his cinematographer, Dante Spinotti, shoot on high-definition digital video, the images are both contemporary and timeless. 3 stars for Public Enemies. For the Chicago Tribune, I'm Michael Phillips.